Hi guys, welcome back with another Shopify tutorial. And in today's tutorial, we are learning how to add collapsible accordion on your Shopify product description. So if you have a huge description and it's taking a long part of your page, so you should be adding collapsible accordion, which will make your product page look more elegant and decent. So without getting more delayed, let's get into the tutorial. So guys, if you have a Shopify product page where the description is long and you're getting a lot of wide empty space, you can add collapsible accordions in order to make your product page look better. So this is the tutorial which I'll be following. I'll put the link in the description below so you guys can easily follow. Now let's go ahead and do the first step. And in this step, we will add the following code in our theme logic.liquid file. So in order to do that, Let's go to the back end of our Shopify store. And from Shopify store backend, click on online store. And edit your current theme code. Make sure to create a duplicate version if you are working on a live theme, because I don't suggest you break anything on your live theme. So make sure to create a duplicate version before editing the code. Now click on edit code. And from there, search for theme.liquid file. Here's our theme.liquid file. And just below the head tag, we will add following two lines. So copy it and paste it below the head. So I'll just add it on line number 9. Click save. And then go to our second step, which is adding the following code in our theme CSS file. So for that, search for the CSS file, which is theme.css. So click on theme.css file and go down to the bottom of the file. And here we can add our CSS code. So this is our CSS code. I'll copy the code and paste it. Hit save. And now let's go to our JS code. So this code needs to be added in our JS file of your Shopify theme. Now search for JS, and here we have theme.js file. So guys, before we add the JS code, I would like you guys to subscribe my channel, comment on the video below, and let me know if you like this tutorial or if you wanna learn more about Shopify. So I just copied the JS code and pasted it on the bottom of theme.js file, and now I'm gonna hit save. Now this is our fourth step where we will be creating meta fields. And in order to do that, I'll click on settings and then click on meta fields. And from there, I'll click on products. And from there, I'll click on add definition. Now, I'll name this field first tab title, select the content type to be text, and then single line text. Save the definition, and here we have the tab title field created. Now I'll create another field for description. And I'll name it first tab description. Now let's create second tab title, second tab description, and third tab title and third tab description. So I'm gonna do this a little quick. make sure to don't do any mistakes, because the final step is to add the code in our theme.liquid file. And if we do any mistake on creating meta fields, there will be an issue adding those fields. Second tab, description. Description and content type, text, single line. Let's do multi-line text because it's a description. Let me check if I selected proper. Oh shoot, I should have selected multi-line text on this field. So I'll have to recreate this field for that. Delete the field and recreate it because I messed up. Sorry for that. First tab, description. So for description, we'll always be selecting text area because there will be multi-line text on that. Multi-line text. Hit save. Okay, now let's create the final third tab, title, and select single line text, hit save, do the similar with third tab description, and then select content type to be multi-line text. Okay, we have our meta fields created, and now we'll move on to the final step, which is add the following code in our product template liquid file. So one thing I want you guys to make sure that this tab title should be same as the meta field here. So for example, if we want to display the first tab title value, this value should be same as this one. If you have any spelling mistakes, then the field won't be visible. Okay, now let's copy the code and see how it looks. So I'm gonna go back again to edit code. And now I'll search for product template. So that's the file, product-template liquid. And now search for description. So that's the code which we will be replacing, as I already have mentioned in all my tutorial. So we'll have to replace this code with the following code here. Now let's copy the code and paste it. Now hit save. And now let's take a look at our accordions. So let's go to the product page and hit refresh to see how it looks. Okay guys, so we have our accordion showing up, but there is no title and description, right? And for that, we'll have to go to our product page and add in the proper value. So that's our product page. And these are the meta fields which we created. Now let's add in the first tab title and description. And one thing we messed up here is that first tab title and first tab description is misaligned. So let's see if we can rearrange it. So unfortunately, there's no sorting option. So we'll have to add the meta field definitions line by line. So for now, let's just do as it is. So first tab title should be design and details. And then first tab description should be this one here. Copy it and paste it on first tab description. Hit save. Now let's refresh and see how it looks. Finally, we have our accordion showing up. Now let's fill in the remaining two accordion field details. Just copy the title and paste it on second tab title. Description for second tab. Second accordion, sorry. And now let's do the third one, delivery and returns. So that's the third title and the third tab description. Copy and paste it on our meta field, third tab description. Hit save. And now let's hit the refresh button to see how it looks. Okay guys, so we have our three accordions showing up. Looks pretty nice, right? Good thing about them is that they are also mobile responsive. So if you go and check out on your mobile, you can see they are looking pretty nice and clean. That's it for the tutorial, guys. I hope you guys liked it. If you have any confusion, any questions, feel free to leave a comment below. I'll try to answer them as soon as possible. Have a great day.